Now introducing Nico Carney.
What's up, guys? How we doing? Hell yeah. It's so good to be here. I'm Nico. It's been a pretty big year for me. A couple months ago, I came out as trans, which was really exciting. Oh, thank you, guys. Thank you. Yeah, it's been pretty cool. It's been kind of scary, too, though, because, like, I don't know if you guys keep up with the news. But it's, like, a really hard time to be a white man. It was, like, not a good time to buy that stock. I am a trans man, but I feel like a better description of my gender identity is probably JV basketball point guard. Like, he might not ever be big enough and strong enough for varsity, but goddamn if he's not gonna give you four quarters of hustle, okay? The kid's got heart you can't teach. One cool thing about being a trans dude right now is the standards of masculinity have changed a lot. Like, I think about who the heartthrobs were for my parents' generation, maybe somebody like Patrick Swayze. But, like, I could be Timothée Chalamet. That is not a problem. I already look like one cigarette's gonna take me out right now. And now Tom Holland is in, I'm like, this is just getting closer to me. This is excellent news. I could be the next Spider-Man. Yeah? Yeah, thanks. Trans Spider-Man, he's like, he doesn't shoot webs, but just get the job done, you know what I'm saying? It's all good. When I first came out as queer, I came out in college as a lesbian, and I figured that out in the exact place they tell you that's gonna happen to you. I was in a women's college soccer locker room, so. How deeply unoriginal of me. So when I first came out as a lesbian, and since then I've realized myself to be a trans man, and going from being a lesbian to being a straight man is devastating, you guys. I could have died the hero, but I lived to see myself become the villain. That's my Joker origin story. It's been a good year though. I started taking testosterone this year. That was cool. Yeah, I've been on it for a little while. I've kind of seen myself go from like Pixar character to Pixar character's older brother. That's kind of my journey with it. It was cool that when I first started taking it, one of the first things I noticed that changed in me was that I was really hungry all the time. And I was at a show and there was a bunch of straight guys in the audience. So I asked them, are you guys like really hungry all the time? And they were like, yeah, we are! And nobody's talking about it! I was like, okay, I mean, to turn this into a men's rights rally, Jesus Christ! Just wanted to know if those tummies were rumbling, boys, that's all I asked, okay? When I first went to the doctor to get my prescription for testosterone, she told me there's two ways you can take it. So there's an injection with a needle, which is pretty standard, and there's also a gel you just like rub on your skin and it absorbs in. So there's the injection or the gel. And when she told me these were my options, I thought she was testing me. I'm like, oh, you're gonna rub a little gel on your skin or you're gonna man up and stab yourself? Like, I feel like if I asked for the gel, she would have been like, you are not ready for this. Go do some push-ups, listen to Joe Rogan, get back to us later. And then maybe we'll talk. I'm not allowed to use the gel because if it doesn't absorb all the way in your skin and it touches somebody else, there's a chance it could transfer to them. So if you work with kids, they don't let you use it. And for my day job, I'm a youth soccer coach. So not good for like the kids' safety. But also I don't want to become like the next Fox News headline. It's like they're turning our kids into transgenders at soccer practice. You should blame Megan Rapinoe. She is behind that. I love working with kids. It is kind of interesting to be going through this early stage of my transition while working with kids because they got a lot of questions and they don't have a filter. So, vulnerable position to be in. And I get three questions all the time. The first is always, are you a boy or a girl? And I'll say I'm a boy. And a six-year-old will look me in the eye and go, no, you're not. Because they understand as well as I that gender is a myth and life is a prison, okay? And then the second question I get, they'll say, how old are you? And I'll say, I'm 24. And they'll say, oh, I thought you were a kid. Which I already knew because they do not respect me. And I know they don't respect me because one day I showed up wearing like a black polo shirt, part of our coaching uniform, and they spent the entire practice calling me Tuxedo Boy, Tuxedo Boy. That's not how you speak to an adult you respect that's a peer you think you can bully, okay? So they say, are you a boy or a girl? How old are you? And then the third question is always, do you have a wife? Which is so out of left field considering the other conclusions they've made about me. I'm like, what do you think of me? This is Coach Nico, a lesbian child bride? What are we talking about right now? I had a five-year-old kid I work with, Beatrice, came up to me one day and said, Coach Nico, I didn't know you were a boy who used to be a girl. And this is in front of the whole team, so they're all like, you have something to explain. Coach Nico, I didn't know you were a boy who used to be a girl. And I was like, who told you that? And she goes, oh, Millie did, who is another five-year-old on the team. And this is why I love working with the kids, because these are really cool teachable moments. It's good for me, it's good for them. So I called her over, I was like, hey, Millie, come here a second. Keep my name out of your fucking mouth. I'm Nico Carney. Keep it going for your host, guys.